Hello guys, a very good morning to all of you. So guys, I hope that you have seen the GDP projection session that I took yesterday. But if you have not seen that session for the upcoming examination, then guys do see that session because that is very helpful for your RBI Grade B examination. All the latest GDP projections have been provided there. Now, myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs, and in this video, I will be taking up a lot of important questions for your upcoming RBI Grade B examination. So let's begin this video. But before that, if you are coming for the first time, then guys, do subscribe our channel and hit this bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where we provide you with the free quizzes as well as we provide you the latest updates about the examination or the new videos that we are going to upload. You can also ask your queries here. So if you want to get your queries resolved instantly, then you can join this group. And the link is in description below. So guys, this is our new course that we have launched for the upcoming examination. That is the year 2022. So this course has a lot of perks for you guys because this is the new course on the new pattern. It has a descriptive type of module on which we have prepared the entire course, and it is clearly based on the RBI pattern. Also, the mocks that we have provided are again on the pattern of RBI Grade B examination that RBI has introduced right now. So guys, what are the specific things that you will get in this course? The specific things are the books. We will be sending you a book bundle which will include four books. First will be phase one book, which will have quant reasoning English in it, as well as past years from 2010 onwards. Also, you will have the summary sheets book for phase two of your examination. So in this booklet, you will have the summary of the static or the entire course of finance, economics and social issues. So this summary sheets is for phase two. Then we will send you an essay book. So this essay book will have essays written in it so that you will get an idea how to write the essays in the examination, as well as you will be given topics for this. In this book for practice. Also, apart from these three books, you will also get a question bank for phase two for practice. So these are the four books that we will send you if you enroll in this course. So if you want to prepare for the examination and you want to get yourself enrolled in some course, then this, guys, is a good option for you all. So on that note, I'm ending this discussion and moving on to our first question. Okay. So our first question is, who has been appointed as the Managing Director General of Asian Development Bank? So you have the five options. Out of these five options, the right answer is Woo-chung Oh. And which country does he belong to? He belongs to South Korea. Whenever, guys, there is an appointment to an international organization, your first responsibility is to check that which country does that person belong to. So he belongs to South Korea. Woo-chung Oh. Now, who is the president of Asian Development Bank? This is your question to tell me in the comment section below. Tell me who is the president of this Asian Development Bank. Next, where is the Narendra Modi Stadium located? So why is this stadium in the news? Or do you know that there is a stadium called Narendra Modi Stadium in India? And also an interesting fact related to this stadium that I would like to tell you is that it is the world's largest cricket stadium. Now, where is it located? So we have Bharuch, Motera, Jamnagar, Kheda, Junagadh in the options. All these five are districts of Gujarat. So now, where is it located? It is located in Motera. Now I hope that many of you have already got confused here. So Motera Stadium or Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel Stadium, which is the world's largest cricket stadium at present, has been renamed as the Narendra Modi Stadium today itself. So this is why, that is why it is in the news, that because the Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel Stadium has been renamed. Now guys, this is the world's largest cricket stadium in accordance with the spectator capacity, the visitors capacity, that is 1.35 lakh people can sit inside this stadium. And by virtue of this capacity, this stadium is the second largest stadium, sports stadium in the world. So this is again an important fact related to this Narendra Modi Stadium. Now, where is this Motera? It is in Ahmedabad. Okay, so we have discussed everything. Now I mentioned here that it is the second largest sports complex in the world. Now, which one is the first? Do find it out and tell me in the comment section below. So if you are not able to find the right answer, then also mention it. I will tell you the right answer in the next video or in the comment section itself. Okay, so the third question is, which of the following state union territory has entered in the governing council of Niti Aayog for the first time? So Niti Aayog governing council has been reconstituted very recently, and that is why this question is in news. Now, which union territory or the state has entered into this governing council for the first time? So we have Telangana, Lakshadweep, Ladakh, Daman and Diu, and Dadra and Nagar Haveli, which were earlier two union territories but now have been merged into one union territory. Then we have Jammu and Kashmir. So which one is the right answer of this question? So the right answer is Ladakh. Ladakh has become the first union territory to enter, basically not the first, Ladakh is the union territory that has entered the governing council for the first time. Now I need to tell you the important designations in this governing council. So the chairperson is Prime Minister, ex officio. So presently the chairperson of this governing council is Narendra Modi. Vice chairperson is Rajiv Kumar. So this is an important designation again. Then we have CEO, that is Amitabh Kant. So these are the three designations that are very important in the Niti Aayog organization. So that's all for the constitution. Now, apart from the main designations, there are members also in this governing council. So who are the members? Chief ministers of all the states and union territories with legislatures. Now, how many union territories have legislature in India? There are three union territories, Delhi, Puducherry and Jammu and Kashmir. So these are the three union territories, and the chief minister of these three union territories are the members of this governing council. Who are the special invitees? So this governing council also has special invitees, and the special invitees are the lieutenant governors of all the remaining union territories. So that is the constitution, complete constitution of this governing council of Niti Aayog. I hope that it is clear to you guys. Now the third question is very important for us. Which state has established India's first digital university? Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka and Kerala. So what is the right answer? The right answer is Kerala. Kerala has established this first digital university. The full name of this university is Kerala University for Science, Innovation and Technology. Kerala University of Science, Innovation and Technology. Now guys, this university is an upgraded version of Indian Institute of Information Technology and Management in Kerala. So basically this Indian Institute was already existing and it has now been upgraded to to this Kerala University of Science, Innovation and Technology, which is the first digital university of India. Now, guys, who is the first chancellor of this new digital university? So the governor of Kerala is also the chancellor of this university. And what is the name of the person? This is your task to find out and mention in the comment section below. The governor of Kerala, I'm again repeating that the governor of Kerala is also the chief chancellor of this university. Now, guys, we are leaving a very important point here. That is the exact location of this university. Where is it exactly located in Kerala? So this is the exact name of the place where this university is located. And why did I tell you this thing? Because it is important. It can happen that the exact place can be asked from you in the upcoming RBI Grade B examination. Therefore, you should be aware of the exact place where this first digital university of India is located. That is Techno City, Mangalapuram. So this place is near Thiruvananthapuram. So guys, these were the facts related to this university. Now let's go deeper into the concept of digital university. What do we mean by digital university? So digital university is the university which is offering the courses in digital technologies. So the courses or the content offered by this university is in the field of digital technologies and advanced AI and machine learning technologies. You would also come across Xavier University if you search India's first digital university on Google. So if you type this phrase, India's first digital university of India, then the first link that would appear is of Xavier University. So is Xavier University India's first digital university? The answer is no. It is India's first digitized university. Digitized university. What is the difference between this university and this university, Xavier University? This university is offering the courses, the content in the digital sphere, whereas Xavier University has its infrastructure digitalized. Therefore, it became the first digitized university of India. So digitized is in reference to the infrastructure and the methodology of teaching in the university. Now, where is it located? It is located in Bhubaneswar, Odisha. Xavier University. So do remember the place as well, because it is India's first digitized university. Now, at this note, all the facts related to this university ends. But my question from you is that who is the chancellor of this university? And you should not forget to answer this question in the comment section below. Where is the Dhubri Fulbari Bridge being built? So you have Assam and Meghalaya, Odisha and Telangana, Andhra Pradesh and Kerala, Maharashtra and Karnataka, Tripura and Nagaland in the options. Which one is the right answer? The right answer is option A. Assam and Meghalaya. So this Dhubri is in Assam and Fulbari is in Meghalaya. Guys, why is this bridge so important? The reason behind this is that it is India's longest bridge that is being developed. It is of 19 kilometer. So this bridge is India's longest bridge that you have to remember being built in Assam, basically Assam and Meghalaya, from Dhubri to Fulbari. Now, apart from this, recently Prime Minister Narendra Modi, apart from laying the foundation stone for this bridge, he also did the Bhumi Pujan for another bridge in Assam only. And what's the name of that bridge? It's Majauli Bridge. Majoli or Majuli, whatever you want to say. So this bridge from Majuli to Jorhat. So both these places are in Assam. So this is another bridge that is being built in Assam. Now there is also a peculiarity attached to Majuli. And what is that peculiarity? That is, it is the world's largest river island. This is the peculiarity of Majuli. Majuli is the world's largest river island, and both these bridges are being built on Brahmaputra River. So on the Brahmaputra River, these two bridges are being built. So this is again an important fact that can be asked from you in the examination. So these two bridges have been recently launched or inaugurated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi along with a mission. And what is that mission? The name of the mission is Mahabahu Brahmaputra. So basically, under this Mahabahu Brahmaputra mission, there are two purposes that the government aim to serve. First purpose is to increase the connectivity in the eastern area, in the eastern India. And second purpose is to provide or is to implement the development projects along the basin of Brahmaputra River, as it is mentioned in the name of this project itself, as well as River Tarak. So two rivers are there. First is Brahmaputra and second is Barak. And both these rivers are in the northeast of India, and these two rivers are not confined into one state only. So these two rivers flows into many states of the northeast India and alongside the basin of these two rivers in different states. Development projects will be launched under this mission, Mahabahu Brahmaputra mission. So this was all for this mission. Apart from this, so these three were the launches by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Assam government has also launched a scheme recently, and that scheme is urbanization scheme. So under this urbanization scheme, the public transportation will be improved. So basically, the people who are looking to drive the buses or to drive to do anything for their self-employment, so they can go to the bank, avail the loan and buy the buses and drive them on the roads. So basically, it will serve two purposes: public transport and second purpose is entrepreneurship. So basically, under this urbanization scheme, loans will be given only for purchasing the public transports like buses. And the second purpose is the entrepreneurship. So these are the four launches that have been taken place recently in the state of Assam. Who is the CM and governor of Assam? So these are the two questions that you have to answer in the comment section below. Okay, so after discussing so many complex things, now we are on a simpler question. So which of the following union territory has signed an MOU with V-Hub to promote women entrepreneurship and startup culture in the union territory? So you have the five union territories. Which one is the right answer? It is Jammu and Kashmir. Now, V-Hub belongs to Telangana. And basically, it is the incubation center that has been set up by the government of Telangana to increase the opportunities for women entrepreneurs. So basically, it is the first state-led incubation program for women entrepreneurs in India. So this is a special thing about V-Hub. And in the recent time, it has partnered with Jammu and Kashmir. Also, it has partnered recently with Gujarat. It is again a very recent partnership that V-Hub has done with iHub of Gujarat, industry hub of Gujarat. So these are the two recent partnerships of V-Hub. Who is the governor of Jammu and Kashmir? Tell me in the comment section below. Next question. Which of the following state-owned bank has been recently put under RBI's regulation? So question to padhne mein hi is very important. It is looking very important and it is a very important question from your upcoming examination point of view. Okay, so you have the five banks right in front of you. Out of these five banks, it is the State Bank of Sikkim that has been put in under the administration of RBI, under the regulation of RBI. So basically, it is 100% state-owned bank. It was the 100% equity of this bank is held by the state government of Sikkim. And the static fact related to this bank is it was established in the year 1968. And 1968 mein establish hua hai and its 100% equity is with the government of India. So does that mean that after this regulation or after this step, the State Bank of Sikkim would come under RBI's ownership? The answer is no. The ownership will remain the same. That is, the state government of Sikkim will hold the ownership of this bank. It's just that the regulation of this bank will come under RBI as it is in the case of other banks. So basically, under the Banking Regulation Act, as RBI regulates other banks, it will regulate this State Bank of Sikkim as well from now onwards. So that is why this question is important and that is the significance of putting this bank under RBI's regulation. So that's all for this question. But again, my question is remaining. And my question is managing director of this bank. Tell me in the comment section below. Next. Who has been appointed by RBI to promote its public awareness campaign on cyber frauds on its Twitter handle? So you have the five singers right in front of you. You can read them on your own, and if you know the answer, then you can also write them in the comment section below. And towards the end of this video, you can yourself judge your score, that how many questions you did right and how many you did not know. So you learned from this video. Okay, now the right answer is option B, virus. So he's basically a Punjabi singer as well as a rapper. And he came into limelight because of the song Bum Bole. Because in the recent movie Lakshmi, Akshay Kumar wali movie, in that movie, the song Bum Bole was originally created by him and it was recreated for the movie. And because of this, he came into limelight very much. Particularly in the Bollywood sphere. So he came into limelight. Now, so this is a very basic appointment question, but because I saw Twitter here, I remind that RBI is India, is the world's first central bank, or we can say that it broke the record of central banks as it has the highest followers on Twitter. So basically, it's India's central bank that has the highest followers on Twitter among the central banks. Remember this thing? We are taking into the central banks in comparison, not the entire world. So in comparison to the other central banks of major economies, it's the Indian central bank that has the highest number of followers on Twitter. Apart from this, RBI runs a campaign. RBI kehta hai. So basically, this campaign was started in the year 2016 by RBI on various social media channels like Twitter, YouTube, Facebook. And what is the purpose of this RBI kehta hai? It is basically a public awareness campaign under which various themes like cyber fraud are being taken by the RBI. So that's all for this question. I hope that you can remember this part as well. So RBI kehta is an important initiative of RBI, and remember that this campaign is available in 14 languages. So this is again an important fact. 14 languages, RBI kehta hai. Next question is from sports. Where will second edition of Khelo India University Games 2021 be held? So you have Haryana, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh in the options, and the right answer is Karnataka. So in the Bangalore's Jain University, this Khelo India University game will be held. So basically it's the second edition of this game. Now Khelo India program was started in 2018. It has three branches under it. First is youth, Khelo India Youth Games. Second is university. And third is winter. So in youth, it was earlier the Khelo India School Games, and now it has been renamed as youth. What is the age limit? What is the maximum age limit for the students to participate in this Khelo India Youth Games? It is under 17. Now why I am telling these things? Because this is a very important program of the government of India. Therefore, these basic facts can also be asked from you. And remember that you have descriptive paper this year, so you can use these facts as well in order to substantiate your answers in the descriptive paper. Okay, universities, it's 25, under 25. And winter, there is no age limit. So guys, fourth Khelo India Youth Game will be held in Youth Game. So it is the Youth Game. Haryana Panchkula is the 2021 venue, and here 2020 venues are there. University Games, Karnataka, last year it was held in Bhubaneswar. Winter Games, Gulmarg, Jammu and Kashmir, it is the expected venue, and last year it was the first edition of Khelo India Winter Game that was held in Leh and Gulmarg. So Gulmarg is in Jammu and Kashmir. Okay. Who has won the women's single in Australia Open 2021? So Australia Open is one of the four Grand Slam tournaments that are conducted in the world. So who has won the women's single? It is Naomi Osaka. She is from Japan. Who has won it in the male category? It is Novak Djokovic. And he is from Serbia. So this is the major tournament that has taken place right before your examination. Therefore, these minute questions can also be asked from you. So these are the important things related to Australia Open. So here, this video ends. I hope that you have enjoyed this video and learned a lot during the video. So if you have done that, then you should share this session with your friends as well so that they can also get a chance to learn. Thank you so much for watching the video.